Yes, good morning. Good morning, children. Before we start the chapter new one, the bond of love, let me make it more clear, like what is to be done regarding the previous chapter, that is reach for the top, second part. From there, okay. Yes, from there, page number is 109, writing part. Look at that part. Look at your books. So go through the table below that gives you information about the top women tennis players since 1975. So we have got complete information about the tennis players from the times of 1975. Write a short article for your school magazine comparing and contrasting the players in terms of their duration at the top. So this is the table which is there in front of us. That is the role of honor of women who enjoyed life at the summit since everybody's favorite player. So Chris Evert took her place in 1975. So then the thing is, write a short article for your school magazine comparing and contrasting the players in terms of their duration at the top. Like which player was at the top for how much time? That is the main thing. So what your article is about, you'll be talking about the players who were at the top and for how much time they were there at the top. It's said like it's very easy to be at the top, not very difficult. It's not very difficult to come first in something. But the more difficult thing is to stay there for a longer time. Okay, consistent people, you know, they are there in that, role of honors, either as first or as being second or third. And some children, you know, they come first sometimes and they never ever, they are never seen there after five years. So because they are not consistent. Anyone can be first, mind it. The moment somebody wakes up and works hard and can be the topper. But the people who are consistent, perseverant, strong-willed, and are able to sacrifice, are only able to keep it to the top. Others come down. So here article is not about like talking about the top players in tennis. What you have to basically talk about, the tennis players who were at the top and could stay there for longer. So write an article for your school magazine comparing and contrasting the players in term of their duration at the top. Underline it. In term of their duration at the top. What does it mean? You'll be comparing and contrasting the players who could remain the topper for a longer time. Those who could, like which player was able to remain the topper for a longer time? For how much time was he or she there? Mention some qualities that you think may be responsible for their brief or long stay at the top spot. So what you have to focus upon? Mention the qualities that you think may be responsible for their brief or long stay. So you have to basically focus upon like why some player remained at the top for a shorter time, or you have to focus like why the other player remained out at the top for a longer time. Okay. So which quality would be there in the player who might have been there for a longer time? Consistency. Okay. Sacrifice. Determination. Perseverance. Willpower. Right? Yeah, patience. Desire can make you come first for once. The moment you come first, the desires, you say, yeah, I did it. Then consistency is lost. Okay, now come to the second point. So this article you'll be writing today, you'll view this chart. So Maria Sharapova, so weeks as number one. So there is somebody who remained at the top. That was the one who remained is...
Chris Evert.
Huh? So see, there are some people, those who were there for a longer period of time. So view this chart on your own. Tomorrow, this article will be discussed in the class, and the best write-ups will get the incentive. It can be in any form, prize. Okay, best three articles. Originality is very important. Originality and your own ideas, and then when you'll be able to put up or give the best, that will be considered. So copy work will not be appreciated. Yeah, you can take ideas. Now in the second part, children, because in the first part you were asked to write a few qualities of the people, those who were the toppers. So these are the words which will help you write up your article. So which of these words would you use to describe Santosh Yadav? So find reasons in the text to support your choices and write a couple of paragraphs describing Santosh's character. So these words are there to describe Santosh and her character. So that is second thing you'll be doing today. So first is a comparison and contrast among these women who remained at the topmost position in the tennis world. And second is the character sketch of Santosh Yadav, thereby taking the help of these words which are written there. So these two questions you'll be doing. And tomorrow these two questions will be discussed. And otherwise also there will be an oral test of the whole chapter, the reach for the top overall. Oral test that will be here on the screen. And that very video will be shared on YouTube, you all know. Okay, and I'll be personally requesting your parents to watch that. Because parents often come to us and they ask us, like, how is our child doing? Sometimes they call us, like, how is our child doing in the class? I'll say, like, see this video. Okay, all of yours, a turn will come. Okay, in a period of 35 minutes, we'll try to cover up 30 children tomorrow. Okay, the rest of the students will be covered day after tomorrow. Okay, now the bond of love. Now let's start this chapter. What is the bond of love? Okay. Yes. So bond of love is the bond which a mother shares with her son or children, which children share with their parents. So that bonding which connects humanity together. Okay. Bond of love is the bond which connects all together. And this bond even connects the humanity with the flora and fauna also. Okay, this love is not only between human beings only. Even we get connected to the animals around us. I'm not just talking about the pets. Okay, the people, those who have the pets, you know, they cannot live without their pet, right? Because that pet becomes their family member. So love for the pet is just like something which is not worth mentioning even. But I want to say, like, when we, feeling of love or compassion is such which makes us get connected to the whole flora and fauna also. When we have a tree around us, suppose we have a tree in our vicinity or near our house, even that tree we start loving. Okay, if somebody tries to touch that tree, we don't like it. Okay, let me give you one more very clear example. I'm saying that love, even we also start getting we also start loving even the plants around us, the plants which we have at our own house. Don't you feel a bond of love for them? If you don't, then try. You must be. If that plant is dying, if that plant is not doing well, then you feel bad. So the point is, like, we have a connection with even the plants in our house. Then what about human beings? How can a human being hate somebody else? Okay, if there is a plant near our house, which we have not even, you know, done anything with, but we even start developing our bond for that also tree. Okay, so same is about the plants in our house, same is about the animals, not only the pets, even around our house. There are many street dogs. I guess many of you people, you know, pamper the street dogs also. So the moment somebody is not well, people become so concerned, they even share the pics like this dog is not well, want a doctor for him or her. So this is the bond of love. Some people call it kindness. Some people call it compassion. Yes, compassion, kindness is, you know, there because of the bond of love. When love is missing, then cruelty starts. Then hatred comes up. Okay, hatred and what else? Cruelty. They find room when love is not there. So bond of love connects us all, not only us, but even the whole creation of God. Even a small, you know, insect is the creation of God. Unless and until it is very, very harmful, we don't mean any bad for anyone. Okay? We, especially the Indians, we don't feel like killing any animal till the end. Not even an insect. Isn't it? So let's see what this bond of love is in this chapter. Right? So, whenever the chapter is being done, what we always do? I just read, you people explain. I don't explain. You know, you people will be explaining whatever I read. Would that be fine? Can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals?
Yes.
Just now we have discussed this.
Wild animals.
Yeah, even wild animals. Yes. Yes. There are examples. Yes. Okay, let's start off. So let's read a fascinating account of an orphaned sloth bear that was rescued by the author. So here we are going to read about Dash. Rajvinder, we are going to read about Dash. We are going to read the story about a bear. We are going to read the story about a bear, sloth bear. You'll be telling me the meaning of sloth when you read about what kind of bear is it. Okay, let us try to see like how we can derive the contextual meanings also. Okay, we don't know the meaning of sloth so far. But the meaning of sloth will come in the very first or second paragraph, the moment the writer will start describing the bear. So let's read a fascinating account of an orphaned sloth bear that was rescued by the author. So rescued means saved. So author saved a bear. Keshav? No. Sloth bears inhabit forested areas. Sloth bears inhabit. Inhabit means, Keshav? Inhabit means? Dwell, live. So these bears can be found in the forested areas, including the tropical rainforest of India and grasslands at lower elevations. So they can be found in the tropical rainforest of India and the grasslands at lower elevations. What are elevations? What are elevations, Jaskaran? What are elevators? What is elevation, elevator? Yes, very good. Elevator, you call lift as elevator. You know? And the elevator, what does the lift do? What does the elevator do? It makes you go up. So what is elevator then? height. Okay, elevation is height. So where were we? So sloth bears, they live in the forested areas, including the tropical rainforests of India and the grassland at lower elevations. Sloth bears have very shaggy hair. All of you look, sit straight. Look at the book. Look at the book. Put fingers on the lines which I'm reading. Sloth bears have very shaggy hair and long muzzles. Shaggy hair means, what is shaggy? Dirty. Or, okay, fluffy or shaggy. Shaggy is basically dirty also. Using their claws to dig, they can then use their lips to form a tube, which can go deep into the ground or into hard to reach areas like dead trees for their food. So each animal has been given a special kind of feature so that it can survive. Okay. So what makes it have food from the deepest side of the earth also? Its claws. Their main food is termites. You can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. You can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. So what does it mean? Yes, very good. Just Karan ke liye clapping karwaj. He's so attentive and giving very quick answers. Okay, very good. So you can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. So you can hear them sucking, that is eating their food, even when you are at a distance. Okay. I'll begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. I got him for her by accident. So what's the name of the sloth bear? Bruno. So the author got it for his wife. 2 years ago, look at the book. It is very, very important to bring the book. I'll begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. I got him for her by accident. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. Is it possible that when I'm reading the chapter, you are talking and you are understanding? You do. But where is a niche? Quiet. Very, very minor habits, you know, we need to change. Not very alarming habits. But the minor habits make you lose a lot. Two years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. Some were shot and some escaped. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out panting in the hot sun. Panting means heaving, sighing heavily. Okay, sighing fast. When you're very tired, when you run, then afterwards you breathe in a very fast manner. That fast breathing is called panting. P-A-N-T-I-N-G. Okay? Got it? I'm reading out the paragraph again, then somebody will be asked to explain it. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. Explain this much. Yes, Navneet. Okay, this much only. author says like they were passing through the fields in Mysore, and they saw some people were making the pigs leave their fields by shooting at them. They were firing at them. So when they saw that some people were firing at the pigs, then what happened? I'm reading it. Then somebody will be asked to explain it. Some were shot and some escaped. Anshar, explain. Yes. So because some people were firing at the pigs. As a result, some pigs were killed and some managed to escape. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out, panting in the hot sun. Lavanya. Okay, 99.9% it was correct. Only one mistake she committed. Can anyone tell what was that? Yes, yes, yes. So line is like, we thought that everything was over. The author thought like everything, like all the pigs either have escaped or have been killed. They thought like now no other pig is there in the field. But no. They were wrong, because there and then they saw that one sloth bear came in front of them, who was breathing very fast. Why was it panting? It
because of the hot sun. Because he was scared.
Okay, one boy says because it was very hot, sun was there. He says because he was scared. Yeah. Anyone else? One by one, Manavi. Okay, somebody else. Why was he panting? He was tired from running. Very good. So both of you, correct answer. So the point is, of course, he might have struggled to run away. He might have struggled to escape from that firing and all. So because he might have run very fast, so now he was panting. He was breathing very fast. You take 10 rounds of the ground. Then afterwards, see what will you do? I'm saying 10. You take one round of the ground. Then you will start panting. Because you are not habitual of playing now. Okay. So tomorrow, be ready for the quiz. I mean oral test.